Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in fabulous Las Vegas, or so that's what they call it. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless everyone. I'm here visiting with the brothers and sisters who I met with last time, and by the grace of God, some new people too. Got one demon to cast out too on Friday, so I ask you guys to pray about that. There's a young man who I prayed with last time, and he was doing pretty good, and then someone had prayed with him to get saved, to receive the Lord again, and from my understanding, and then he started saying that he was the Son of God. So he either A, is planning on starting a YouTube channel and having actual people believe him, or B, he needs to be delivered from this demonization that he's involved in. So, based on some of the characters on YouTube, maybe he would be very successful. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm going to be making a teaching video later on. But first, as you guys know, I usually don't get into current event news too much, because it ends up being lots of speculation and false alarms and over exaggeration. But I'm going to put the link below of an article, and it's called Obama Pledges Declaration of Palestinian State in 2014. And it's a very interesting article, and these are very interesting times. So this is just the kind of thing, even though this deal may not work, it may fall through. And lots of people I know are thinking that it's Obama is the one to confirm a covenant for many for 7 years. But this is a situation of the U.S. coming out and declaring a Palestinian state is a potential to be a regional war. It's going to create lots of instability, which could then usher in the Antichrist. But the part I wanted to look at, that where the Lord has got me looking at the whole thing, is right here, is where it says speculation over the role of the Vatican increased this week. This is in the article. It talks about them declaring a Palestinian state. I'm going to put the link under here. Speculation over the role of the Vatican increased this week after a secretive meeting took place between the Jerusalem municipality, the prime minister's office, that's Netanyahu, and senior Catholic officials. The Catholic delegation is reported to have pressed for control over the compound that houses the traditional Hall of the Last Supper. Well, that's already old news, and they've been trying to get that place for a long time. With some rumors that such a move could be linked in anticipation of the Pope Francis's visit to Israel in May. It is expected that any proposal for a Palestinian state would be a temporary fix lasting 2 to 3 years. Of course, the covenant will be a 7-year deal to allow for security arrangements to be ironed out between Israel and the Palestinians. Okay, you can read this article, and what it's saying is we don't know what's going to happen in there. Is it talks about at the end of the article how that in the book of Joel it says that God judges the nations for dividing the land. So of course that's what's going to happen. So I just want to put that out there, just to get a news article out there and get the right thing about it. I know already in advance, without seeing anything on the internet, there's people that's going to run wild and just keep focusing on Obama. But this is a lot bigger than Obama. The land of Israel, as the Bible told us, would be a cup of trembling and a stumbling block to any nation that tries to mess with Jerusalem in the end times. So this is bigger than Obama. Of course, there'll be no real peace until the Messiah returns. That's why it says in the Old Testament to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Of course, Jesus is the true Prince of Peace. And only when he returns, and destroys the Antichrist and his army, and brings about his millennial reign, the 1,000-year reign of Christ, will there really be peace in Jerusalem. But the Antichrist, who is the first seal that's open in the book of Revelation, I believe it's chapter 6, on the white horse, he goes out with a bow, but no arrows. In the Old Testament, Daniel tells us he conquers through diplomacy, through dark sentences, it's talking about. He conquers through peace and diplomacy, and deception. So the Antichrist will bring about a false world peace that's also known as that confirming a covenant with many for 1 7, period of sevens, which like we say decade, is a period of 10 years. And throughout the book of Daniel, it refers to days as years. So it's in the King James, it'll say for 1 week. But it's a period of seven, which for the Israelis, for Hebrew, is like a decade for us, 10 years. Shavua is a seven-year period for them. Anyway, brothers and sisters, that's what we have to look for. It'll be an agreement that is 7 years, and it will divide the land of Israel. It'll allow for the rebuilding of the temple and a false peace with all the neighbors, and the Muslims was going to love it. The Israelis are going to love it. They'll think that the world leader who brings this is possibly the Messiah. There'll be rumors that he's the Messiah. And, you know, it'll grow until the point that he will go into the temple, on the new temple that will be built on the Temple Mount. That's when we know we're in the tribulation too, when there is a temple built there. He will go in there at midpoint after the first 3.5 years and declare himself to be God, not only the Messiah. See, the Israelis don't necessarily think the Messiah is God. They think he is like another Moses or, you know, some great man, a prophet, not necessarily God. So when they start considering that the Antichrist is the Messiah, and there's insinuation that he's the Messiah, for them that's not necessarily blasphemy. It's just when he's going to really come out and say, I am that I am, when he goes into the temple and probably copying the type of, you know, this Ananias the Fourth Epiphanes, who went in, as I mentioned in a video the other day, who went in there and sacrificed a pig and set up a statue of Zeus inside the Holy of Holies. He's probably going to do something like that, because of course for the law of Moses, a pig is filthy, and of course it would be an abomination under the law of Moses for the Israelis to have a pig being sacrificed, like what that guy did before, as I just mentioned, about 165 BC. So it's something going to be like that. He'll go in there and declare himself to be God, the abomination that causes desolations. That's mid-trib, brothers and sisters. And before that, there will be a temple, and they will. In the book of Revelation, tells us there's an exact amount of days that they will prophesy, or that the temple will. They will offer sacrifices in the temple. That'll be in the first half. It also tells us in the first half, as I'm on this, it's a little teaching. It gives the exact amount of days that the two witnesses will be witnessing there in Jerusalem at the Temple Mount. Basically, there, right there, of course, in Jerusalem at the Temple Mount, they'll be witnessing in front of there. For so many days, okay, and then the Antichrist, when he goes in there and declares himself, let me just lay out these facts for, you know, the biblical theology of this. The Antichrist will receive a wound to his head as if he is dead. He will be resurrected, as I mentioned the other day. That's all mid-trib. Then he will come out possessed by Apollyon, proclaiming himself to be God, not just the Messiah in general, but he is the I am that I am. That's when the Jewish people, the Israelis, will wake up and say, hey, this is blasphemy. This guy is the devil. He's not a savior or a messiah, but the devil. And they will turn on him. The two witnesses will be killed, and they'll be resurrected after 3 days, 3.5 days, and the whole world will see them, every eye will see them resurrected and ascend into heaven. The nation of Israel will flee to what is now Petra or Basra in the Bible for the second half of the tribulation. So let me go back to this article. I'll put the link below the video. The point is that I personally do not believe that President Obama is the Antichrist. He hasn't fulfilled any of the prophecies. Any world leader has the potential of being the Antichrist. It could be President Obama. And this, you know, things can change. It could be the Pope or his emissary from the Vatican somehow. It could be one of the young royals, of these European royals, who are not actively running their countries. They're run now by prime ministers, but the royal families are still there of France. Of course, everybody knows about, you know, Prince William and England, but all those European countries, Spain, all those guys, they all have royalty. They all claim royal bloodline all the way back, which would, they literally have the bloodline of the pharaohs. They have the bloodline of Caesar, because they all intermarried. All the royals, even like in the book of Daniel, we see that, you know, when they captured Jerusalem, they took the royal, you know, the royal relatives of the king of Israel, and then they ended up intermarrying with the royals of Babylon. So these royal people, they call them blue bloods for a reason, and I believe it's because they are descendants of the Nephilim. I believe that's true. If you've never watched my videos, I believe the Da Vinci Code has something truth to it, but not pointing to the this lie that Jesus had children with Mary Magdalene, but pointing to the bloodline of the Antichrist. So that's why I believe it's a high possibility that someone who has that bloodline, who can claim that they're Israeli, that they're Jewish blood, royal blood, and claim some type of right to the throne of King David, claim to have the blood right to be the Messiah. So, but yet also Gentile blood, because the Bible interprets itself, and it also tells us that the first beast, who is the Antichrist, rises up out of the sea of nations. That's the Bible interprets itself. So when it says the sea, it's talking about the nations, the Gentile nations. When it says the land, as I've mentioned before, it's talking about the nation of Israel. So the false prophet literally rises out of the land, out of the nation of Israel. So it kind of puts a damper on the interpretation that the Pope is the false prophet. Unless we had a Pope who had Israeli blood, then it would be possible that, yeah, the Antichrist could be the Pope if he was genetically descended from Israel. So I don't think or ever heard anything about this Pope having any Israeli blood. And as I said, the Antichrist is the first beast. He's not a religious leader, but a political leader. This also puts a damper on it being the Pope. But as I said, this is a dangerous time, and the importance of this article is the fact that some things going on like this, where the America and the Vatican and all them trying to divide Jerusalem, make it some kind of an international city, whatever comes out of this is probably going to be that seven-year covenant. It's also probably going to cause some type of a war. It's a very dangerous thing they're playing with. And so they may try to push this through, then the war of Gog and Magog could happen, and then the seven-year, you know, the Antichrist will come and make the seven-year peace treaty. Well, they're trying to ram this thing through. So that's why it's an important thing, is that this is very destabilizing to the region, and a very dangerous, they're playing with fire here to bring about the biblical prophecies that the Bible tells us will happen. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. Don't, you know, there's lots of people with half-baked stuff on YouTube. And by the grace of God, God has put me on here as a biblically trained preacher to try to give you the straight-up theology and not over-speculate and run wild with speculation. But the land of Israel will not be divided and split up until it's time for that seven-year treaty. When they start dividing the land and all this, that's going to be it. There's not going to be any other dividing. There's not going to, you know, so if you see that these things are happening, this, even though we should already be warning people, the whole point of this is the hour is late. And it's only by the grace of God we haven't had a nuclear war in the world. It's only by the grace of God these terrorists have not gotten hold of a dirty nuclear bomb and haven't detonated it in a major U.S. city or anywhere in the world. It's only a miracle of God. And it's only a miracle of God that they haven't divided the land of Israel. It's because it's in God's timing to the fullness of the Gentiles. That's why, brothers and sisters, it's so important to not get caught up in breaking news and over-exaggeration and all this false doctrine on YouTube, and to get out there and tell people that the kingdom of heaven is at hand, that we are living in the last of the last days, just prior the tribulation could begin at any time, any day. And just prior to that, there will be the rapture of the church. People need to hear that. People need to know that. And of course, what we need to tell them, what's their response? What is someone's response if they realize, hey, something's going on, we're living in the end times. There's chemtrails. There's, you know, the technology's here to track everybody, the mark of the beast. They're trying to divide Israel. There's all these blah, 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 whatever sign you want to look at. All these multiple end time signs, world economic collapse, you know, end of the dollar and all this kind of stuff is at the door, economic collapse. What is someone's response? Well, the response is they need to repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. They need to get right with the Lord. They need to get saved, you know. And there's so much deception, brothers and sisters. I can't believe the deception on YouTube And in the world, of course, the churches are much worse. But I hear on YouTube, famous YouTube people doing New Age teaching, third eye, the third eye teaching of a third eye in your chakra, and all these kind of things, the pineal gland in the brain. This is all going to be the teaching of the one world religion and the false prophet. The false prophet is going to be teaching that exact doctrine that you are a god. And as a matter of fact, I've done teachings on this a long time ago, a couple years ago. Lots of you guys may be new, never seen it. The temple in Luxor is dedicated, is shaped inside, there's it's shaped like the pineal gland. There's a big thing in there, the pineal gland. You know that Egyptian eye you see this famous Egyptian eye, and it's got like a line going down and all this. That is actually a painting of the pineal gland, the pineal gland. And that is the third eye, that is the this new age stuff, which is really old age. That is the all-seeing eye that people are talking about. It's the same thing, and it's like, this is going to be the teaching of the Antichrist and the false prophet, that you are a god, that we're all gods. Just like Satan told Eve in the garden, when you eat this fruit, you will become a god. You'll become like God. That's the lie from the very beginning. The Antichrist is going to tell people when they take the mark, they will become a god. Activate your third eye. And then there's people on YouTube who, for obvious reasons, people shouldn't be watching people that are about theology who are not preachers. And this is a great example of why. Because this is the greatest danger that's facing the people of the world today, and the tribulation period is all about this new age junk that's straight from Satan's mouth in the Garden of Eden. As I just mentioned about the temple at Luxor, which is dedicated to man being a god, actually the Louvre in France, in Paris, France, is based off of this same concept and same design and pattern after that. You know, and if you've been watching my videos over the last two or three years, as the Lord has shown me about the fleur-de-lis and all that stuff, it's connected back through Paris, through France, the Louvre being a great example. I mean, look at this. Let's look at the natural, simple level stuff. Look at the French Revolution and look at the American Revolution. As I've made a video before, the Lord has shown me that you want to see what the tribulation is going to be like? Look at the French Revolution. The French Revolution was an atheist, godless freak show that was an utter failure, and guess what they did to everybody? They chopped off their head. And a secular humanism. The Louvre is a great example of that. Man is God. Now, in the tribulation period, the Antichrist will chop off people's head who don't take the mark. Everybody keeps worrying about the Muslims. France, is it, look at the French Revolution and go study it if you want to see more what the tribulation period is going to be like. And then American Revolution came from people, pilgrims. What do they call them? The pilgrims. What is a pilgrim? A pilgrim is someone who's on a religious quest. America was founded by the Puritan pilgrims, Christians, for freedom of religion. The French Revolution was founded on freedom from religion. Freedom from basically anarchy. Basically a secular humanism. And that is the same message. We can see that if you go study, as I'm going on this topic, and I know lots of people who watch some of my stuff will really be interested in this, who've watched my old videos when I talked all this kind of stuff. The French Revolution was secular humanism, as I'm getting into. And the American Revolution was freedom of religion and liberty and all of those things, the opposite, brothers and sisters. If you want to see God's plan, even though America's got all these faults and all these problems, and yeah, the founders, a lot of them are Masons and all that stuff, the pilgrims and all those guys went there. They made the Mayflower Compact. Go read that. You will see that America was, the people asked for the Lord's blessing, proclaimed the United States for the Lord Jesus Christ from the very beginning, whereas France was secular humanism, demonic. Look at Haiti, which was a French colony. Now, they dedicated Haiti to Satan, and it's the poorest nation in the Western Hemisphere. But they took the secular humanism, you know, because France didn't have that protection of the Lord. When Napoleon Bonaparte was in power was when they had these problems in Haiti. Of course, slavery is evil, but the revolt was led by this voodoo stuff and led to dedicating the nation of Haiti to Satan. That's why they have all the problems they have today, because their country is dedicated to Satan. So how were they able to do that? Because France was already secular humanism. Just like now in Europe, they're being taken over by all this rise and increase of Islam and Sharia law and all that. Why? Because they don't have the protection of God there. It's so bad. So this is the rise of the secular humanism. So that is what we're looking at. You are a god. You are a god. Islam does not teach. Let's just say this. If you're going to try to follow what's going to happen in the end times, Islam does not say that you are a god. It's the opposite of that. The religion of Satan and the religion of the Antichrist and the false prophet is going to be that you are a god. So what teaches that? Secular humanism, communism, socialism, all of these things that's going on. Brothers and sisters, I could go on and on and on and connect all these things as the Lord would lead me so that you can get an idea of where these things are going. I need to do some studying, and then I plan on coming back and making another video by the grace of God, because I have a whole lot more to follow along this topic of what we can look for to see the rise of the Antichrist, the rise of the false prophet, the rise of the New World Order. This is all part of the what's going to be the tribulation period, the last 7 years before the return of Christ that the world is facing. Brothers and sisters, we need to make peace with God now and focus on our personal relationship with the Lord, because only the Lord is our Savior. We need to repent of our sins. We need to dedicate our life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Let me stop this video here. I got to try.